So it's the end of the summer. It's been unreasonably wet here in Montana. Usually it's a lot drier. So our dill, we usually let it dry out the tops of it so we can use it and reseed next year and give it as gifts. But unfortunately this year it stayed wet. So I was just documenting what I was doing to keep those dry. Our dill stays with our strawberries, and this year the strawberries are very happy. They've sent out all of their shoots. And so as I'm pulling the dill and weeding, here are the strawberries that will be tucked in for the winter. And they're just really happy, which makes me happy. So with the dill, we're just pulling it and then separating it. I'm actually burning the tops that aren't fully developed because we do have thousands and thousands of them. And instead of waiting for them to dry outside, which they may not this year, we don't want them all over all the other beds in the garden. So we're cutting off the tops that are really dry. So we'll be using those. And then the ones that aren't developed yet or that are ruined, we're putting in the fire later. So we're collecting those, and they're right there. And then we're cutting off the stalks that are going into the compost back into the garden. And also, if any are still green, we are collecting, of course, the yummy dill part to put in fish or chicken later, which is in the bag. Can we see in the bag? Yes. So we have a little process going here, and hopefully that will keep the dill where it needs to be in the garden and get it out of the wet, because I think we're losing a lot of it to the wetness. And then these bins that I'm using are just, we got these from a car wash years ago, and Sweetie cut them in half. They are fantastic for covering seedlings in the spring when it's cold and wet, even if it snows. It's like a little mini greenhouse. It keeps them protected and insulated, but the light comes through. And then in the fall, they're great for helping collect everything. So they've been really fantastic. We also use them for rain barrels, and that's been really great as well. So all of the rainwater can be collected and put in the garden and the trees.